Hello everyone, I've got a tutorial for you today and it's for this fantasy hot air balloon. So this is my very first collab and it's with ArtMonsterKrys, and so I'm just going to put the link to her video in the description and also put it on the screen. So this hot air balloon is autumn themed with an acorn shell for the base. So first I'm just going to make the balloon. I chose a light salmon color. Just take a medium-sized ball of clay and flatten it down. And use any object that you have to make an indent by pressing it into the clay against your palm. I'm just pulling out the center part so that it makes it more frill-like. And here I'm making a five-pointed sort of star shape with it. And now I'm just going to take my needle tool and make a hole. And I have two needle tools, one small and one big. So first I'm just making the hole, and then I'm using my larger needle tool to widen the hole. Now I'm just smoothing out the rough edges with my ball tool. And I'm also just making a few definitions along the edge to make it ridged. And this is what it looks like. And so now I'm going to insert my eye pin, like this. And so this is what it looks like. And I'm just going to keep that aside for a minute. So for the acorn, I have three different shades of brown. So I have right out of the packet brown, brown mixed with a little bit of white, and brown mixed with a lot of white. So first we're just going to take the middle shade of brown, and I'm doing the same thing again using my makeup brush and pressing it into my hand so that I can make the acorn cup shape. And I'm just using my needle tool to make the crisscross pattern on top to resemble an acorn cap. I would actually advise doing this part later on, just because you're going to be fiddling with it a lot for the next few stages. This is the way I did it, so I'm just going to show it to you this way, and then I'll show you how I redefine it later. And now I'm just taking a toothbrush and texturing it. And so I took my needle tool and just made a hole in the bottom. So now I'm just taking the lightest color clay and I'm just rolling it into a log. And here I'm just using the same makeup brush as a roller and just flattening it out. And I'm just cutting off the section that I want to use and removing the other pieces. Now just pick up the piece and then just wrap it round into a circle so that the ends meet. And just use your needle tool to secure them together. And I'm just using my silicone tool to smooth that line out a little bit better. And now I'm going to insert that circle shape into the acorn base that I made earlier. You can always widen the base if it doesn't fit. And now I'm just using my needle tool to get it in fully, as it did get caught a little bit. And just use your silicone tool to smooth them together a little bit. And now I'm just comparing the acorn bottom to the balloon top to make sure they fit together. And so now, as you can see, I'm redoing those crisscross lines. So this is the time where I would recommend actually doing them at all, as it won't need to be fiddled with quite as much from this point on. And so now I'm just taking my needle tool and making a hole in either side of the acorn. And now I'm just taking the darkest brown clay and I'm rolling it into a thin log with a tapered end, and I'm just cutting the end section off. And you'll have a shape that looks like this. And I'm just redefining that hole that I made earlier so that this piece can fit in there, and using some TLS to make sure it stays in place. And I'm just going to insert the stalk into the top of the acorn. Now go ahead and bake these pieces for just 5 minutes to make them easier to work with. And this is what they end up like. So I'm going to just take the eye screw out, as I'm going to be making the top part of the balloon with another layer on top. So just take the same color clay. Just take a small to medium-sized ball of clay again, and start flattening it out. Once again, I'm using my makeup brush. What a multi-purpose tool. And flatten it out until it gets really thin, and you can tuck the sides to pull it into a more circular shape. It doesn't have to be perfect. Now I'm just laying this flattened piece on top of the balloon part that I made earlier, and press the top so that you can see where the hole is. And now I'm going to gather it at the bottom to make a kind of drapey effect. So what I'm doing is just pressing it in between the places where I made the points earlier, and then I'm just pressing flat the extra flaps that are created. So now I'm just using my tool to redefine some of the indents on the edges. I'm just doing this randomly. I'm And so now you can see the hole through the top. So I'm just using my needle tool to recreate that hole so that I know where the ice screw has to go. And so now I'm using my needle tool to make indents on the top to create the umbrella-like balloon pattern. So what I'm doing is making one right across and then making two others that crisscross as well. So that the entire balloon is divided up into six pieces. And I'm redefining the hole again. It's good to do the hole at the top first because it gives you a guide point so that you know where the lines should meet. And this is what it looks like now. And so now I'm just taking the acorn base and I'm going to create a mossy interior. So I'm using various shades of green here. You can use the same green throughout. I'm just mixing different shades because I find that it makes it look more lifelike. So I'm taking a ball of the darkest shade and just flattening it down and then roughly texturing it with the toothbrush, and I'm just going to press that into the acorn. It doesn't have to be in a perfect circle because once you press it into the acorn, it will take on that shape. And once you get it in, you can texture it some more if you want to. As you can see, my clay was not perfectly mixed, so there is a few lighter and darker patches, but I like that effect. And now for the leaves, I'm just going to use the other different colors of green. So I'm taking a small piece of lightish green. So I just roll it into a ball, flatten it down, and then use my needle tool to make indents along the side. And I'm just redefining those indents and making a line down the middle. And just squashing it again. And now I'm just using some TLS to stick the leaf onto the acorn. And just press it on and redefine using the needle tool. And now I'm taking a really small ball of the yellowish green and I'm just going to repeat the same process, indenting the sides to make an oak leaf shape. And then making the line down the middle. And I'm just going to attach that on as well, so it looks like this. And just make sure it's securely fitted on there by pressing it down with a needle tool.
What?
And now I'm going to shade the balloon top. And so I'm just taking some red chalk pastel on my ever trusty makeup brush. And I'm just dusting it on. I concentrated the color more towards the top to make a kind of gradient effect. And this is what it looks like. And now I'm taking another small ball of clay, a bit bigger than the other ones. And this is going to be for the leaves on the sides of the balloon. And so I'm just pressing it into somewhat of a triangle shape. And now I'm just going to use my needle tool to indent the sides to make that same oak leaf sort of look. I'm just indenting one side. And now I'm just picking it up and re-indenting it. And I'm going to do one more for the other side. Now, I forgot to mention this, but at this stage, it's a good idea to recreate the holes in the top layer of the balloon. So to stick those leaves on the side, just use some TLS. I often use TLS when I'm sticking together two different colors because it's kind of hard to blend two colors that don't match together. So using an adhesive of some sort does help. And then just press it on. It definitely works best to put it on one of the lines. As you can see on this side, the line went a little bit sideways, so I had to put it on the flat part of the balloon. The only thing to remember is to put them just above the holes that you made. And now I'm just making a line down the middle of the leaves. So just using my finger for support, and I'm just doing that for all four sides. Now you can put your eye pin back in. This is what it looks like. So this is optional, but you can also just shade the green parts of the leaves to make them look a little bit more autumnal. So I'm just using the same makeup brush and red chalk pastel and dusting just the tiniest bit on the leaves. So it just gives a sort of softish color to the green. It doesn't make so much difference. So now I'm going to make the crisscross ropes that give the impression of binding the balloon together. For this, I'm just using a top sort of color. So I'm just going to roll it out into a really thin snake. It's easier if you cut it into several sections to continue rolling. So now I'm just going to cut this up into small little strips. So now using my larger needle tool, I'm going to make indents along each side of the lines. And I'm making 8 indents on each line, except for the ones that have the wings on them. Those I'm just making 4. So before you place any strips on, just use some TLFs to make sure they stick. So I'm just taking one of the small pieces and I'm going to use my needle tool to somewhat insert it into the holes. So it looks like that. And I'm just going to do the same with another piece and cross it over the top. It looks like that. And now do this 1,000,000 times. This is the most time-consuming part of the whole hot air balloon, but I think it's worth it for the effect that you achieve at the end. So each set of four holes will have two lines crisscrossing over the top of them. And this is the finished result. So now you're done with all your clay pieces, so you can go ahead and bake these. And this is what they look like. And so now it's time for paint. So now I'm going to start with just some plain white paint and a dotting tool. And I'm just going to cover the balloon with white dots. No particular order to the way I'm placing the dots. And now to make the leaves look more autumnal, I'm just going to add some yellow, orange, and brown, and I'm just going to randomly dot some of these on the leaves. And that's what they look like. And so I'm just going to do the same again with the leaves on the sides of the balloon. And now it's time to glaze your pieces, so I'm just popping mine on a paperclip. So I'm using DuraClear Gloss Glaze and my battered paintbrush, and I'm just going to glaze both of the components individually. I avoided glazing the moss inside the acorn, but I glazed all the other parts. And so now you're just going to take your jump rings. So here I'm starting with the bigger jump ring, and I used a pair of pliers to open them, and now I'm just going to insert it into the hole on the side of the balloon. It might be a tight fit, but just wiggle it through. And now I'm just going to use my pliers to close those jump rings. So first just press them together, and then what I do is hold one side with my hands and the other side with the pliers, and then pull them together fully. This is because I can't operate two sets of pliers, I'm just too uncoordinated. Open the second one and just do the same. Just pull it through and close it with your hand and the pliers, or with two pairs of pliers. And now I'm taking the smaller jump rings, and I'm just going to fit them through the acorn part first, and then onto the first jump ring. And once again, use my pliers to close them together. And then just do the last jump ring the same way. And this is the most tricky jump ring, because everything else is connected. You just got to get that one on the bigger hoop. And you're all done! Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to head on over to ArtMonsterKrys's account and check out her video too. So she also drew a beautiful hot air balloon with a fantasy / steampunk theme. She's an amazing artist herself, but she also gives so much positive feedback for everybody else's work, and I think that's just amazing. So do check her out and subscribe to her as well.